Carl, this special week.
Thank you for having me. I appreciate it.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
So what are you dressed up as this year?
What do you mean?
It's Halloween.
Oh, this is embarrassing, man. I just thought it was casual week.
I thought you thought it was like dress rehearsals or something. And this you is were going to go get dressed. And
this is how I dress normally on when I'm not at work.
You just don't.
Some people will wear some really weird shit. I really shouldn't have given Bob that girl's number. He was dressed in a fuzzy, funny costume earlier this week. Okay. Sorry, Bob. Okay. Anyway, before we move on, I wanted to address the tragedy that happened at our former studios, and it was a complete and total loss, and you know, may Apollo Ono rest in peace. But, you know, like Phoenix from its ashes, we rise bigger and better. And we have this lovely new studio here.
Amazing.
I hope you're happy with the accommodations.
The dressing rooms are amazing. They're spacious. They're big. They've got my bathroom. It's great. It's amazing. Thank y'all for having me.
You're welcome. Anyway, all right. So, Suzuki, you ready to get to the pick?
I'd love to. Well, unanimous picks for A&M, LSU, and Alabama. Kyle and Mac had South Carolina over Tennessee. Ed, Kyle, and Steven had Missouri over Kentucky. What do you think about that?
It seems that that was a bad pick for Missouri and South Carolina.
Or a good pick, depending on how you picked, I guess.
Well, you know, when you lose the pick, it's not good for you. So we had some movement, didn't we?
In sixth place, you want to Mac is now in fifth place, soon to be eclipsed, I believe. Anthony is now in fourth. We're tying second place with Ed and Kyle, and Stephen remains in first place.
Wow.
Do you want to say these, or do I always say them?
You always say
them. Okay. Anthony and Daniel went 10-0, both, each. Mm-hmm. Ed went 8-2. Kyle went 6-4. Oh, yeah. Mac went 8-2, and Steven went 8-2 as well. So we have all of that equaling more movement. And I think the tide's turning.
Well, I don't know. Maybe it is. Definitely Kyle made some movement downward, and despite a perfect week, Daniel was still in sixth place by a long margin. So, anyway.
Well, we had some coverage of the fire from last week, and we're being told that we have to show it to avoid being sued, I believe. So, here you go.
Oh man, this building is on fire. I said, no, what? I got my 3 kids and we bounce out. We ain't being fire, not today.
All right, wow. Well, we're going to...
Operation Foot Golf was a success.
Ed's Herbal Remedies presents Ed's Herbal Steakhouse and Saloon. Best steak around, man. New Outlaw Brownies. A couple of these and they'll just float right on out of here, man. Come on by to the grand opening.
Hey, moron. Were you using the number 2 pencil again? Yeah. Yeah, I bet you were. Yeah, stick to number 3. The number 3 pencil. Right with it, nerd. Yeah, it works, doesn't it? Yeah, yeah. Good job, dummy. Now it works.
Number 3 pencils, because 3 is better than 2.
Welcome back from the commercial. I'm Mike Hunt. This is Kurt Suzuki. Let's see. We have a Twitter question of the week, don't we, Kurt?
We do.
Let's see. It comes from Bear Grylls.
Yeah. Bear Grylls. He's a survivalist.
Yeah. So, did Kyle Platt ever get the fire started in the woods?
An interesting question.
Yeah! Welcome back to the review. That was a great response from Kyle Platt Attack Black.
It really was. I'm glad that he was able to do that. Guys, don't forget, it's award season, and the Academy is already starting to look at all the commercials that have been submitted, so keep up the good work.
All right, I mean, there's almost too many to go through, really, Kurt.
It really is.
All right. Now for our new segment. Questions from kids.
Oh, geez.
Due to the extreme violence and language that was used in the filming of this segment, it must be cut and not used.
Let's get to trash talk.
Enjoy.
Want more crazy trash talk? Here it comes. You asked for it.
Hi, I'm Ed Stewart. You probably know me as Mike Hunt from The Review. Trash talk has been canceled this week. Next week, the entire review itself could be canceled. People at High AF Productions are asking for a little participation. Thank you.
Welcome back from Trash Talk. That was interesting.
Yes, that was. It's quite interesting as unusual. And now let's go to commercial break.
We'll be right back.
Hey guys, Billy Bear! Ray's here with another fantastic product that's sweeping off the shelves coast to coast here in the United States. Today, yes, we're talking about the fart plug. Do you have a farter amongst your ranks? A friend that always thinks that it's so funny just to let one go in tight quarters when it makes everybody break up and fight through a congested crowd? Or do you have a spouse that thinks it's so cute at night to let one go in bed and tuck you and trap you underneath the sheets and give you all that misery? Well, good news for you! Today, we're introducing the fart plug. The fart plug is a convenient little suppository you can insert inside of your friend or your spouse's rectum that makes it equally or more unpleasant for them to any time that they decide to break the social norms of letting that fart go. Comes in three convenient little sizes. Oops! Fluff my panties. The everyday old Mr. Accountable Farter, farting all day guy. And of course, the late night Taco Bell fart stopper. These products are guaranteed to work. They're guaranteed to stop your farter bumps your rate for farting. We gotta end it. It's gotta be over. It's done. Call us today. These are packaged with love. We'll send you all three. Fart plug.
The review is not responsible for the contents of this ad. Under no circumstances are we to be contacted in regards to this ad. All concerns should be directed to the Billy Mays Foundation.
It's a beautiful day in this neighborhood, a beautiful day for a neighbor. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? It's a neighborly day in this beauty wood, a neighborly day for a beauty. Would you be mine? Could you be mine? I've always wanted to have a neighbor just like you. I've always wanted to live in a neighborhood with you. So let's make the most of this beautiful day. Since we're together, we might as well say, would you be mine? Could you be mine? Won't you be my neighbor? Oh, won't you please? Oh, won't you please? Oh, please won't you be. My neighbor.
Suzuki, let's get into the NFL Bench Warmers Fantasy League.
I'm excited about that. Let's do it.
Yes, I'm always excited about fantasy football. So it was a great weekend in fantasy football, and you know, we'll see what happens next week.
Oh, really?
Oh. Hey, it's breaking news from our newsroom.
Let's see what it is. Wow. Young Hoku is now the starting kicker for the Atlanta Falcons.
Really?
Yeah.
Huh. That's impressive. You know, shout out to Young Ho. We love to see the people that come through the show that have been fired really to get their lives back in order. He was really in a dark place after everything happened, and so we're very, very happy for him.
Do you think that they're gonna investigate Young Hoku like they've done Antonio Brown and all these others?
Well, I don't think he's got anything to worry about. The video of the alleged incidents has been smashed and burned and dumped in a vat of acid, then deposited in the sea. So,
that's extreme.
That's almost as good
as bleach bit.
That's been taken care of. So he doesn't have anything to worry about.
Well,
good luck to Young Ho.
Good luck.
And great to see him back in line. So.
Well, I think it's time for the weekend update. She filled my mind up with ideas. I'm the highest in the room. Hope I make it out of here. She saw my eyes, she know I'm gone. I see some things that you might fear. I'm doing a show, I'll be back soon. That ain't what she wanted, yeah. No. Now I go.
got it in my room. Legs wrapped around my beard. Got the fastest car at Zoom. Hope we make it out of here. When I'm with you, I feel alive. You say you love me. All right. That was your weekend update. Thanks for a great, great show. It's so nice that I don't have to end the show with an apology or a or a dead co-host.
That's true. That's true. I'm really sorry about that. It'll get better. Yeah. But it is Thursday night. It is the review. And whenever you go trick-or-treating, stay safe.
Thanks for watching. Could this day get any worse? Jeez. What the fuck is this?
We're done. That's a wrap.
Hopefully.
Good job. Bella, you were pretty quiet.
Daniel,
you don't say anything, Avery. Shut your mouth and act!
I think our directors have lost their minds.
Yes. All right. I'm here to get a watch. The one that tells you when you're going to die, apparently.
Oh, yeah. That's three pickles. Oh,
all right.
Yeah. Thank you. Here you go. Try it on.
That's what I'm doing.
Well, try it on faster. There's a line.
Oh, what the?
Whatever. Who cares? Well,
who right. cares?
Your viewers care.
Ed wouldn't think so. He wants one taken done.
Of course. I can do this. It's
7:45. Oh, he's a pro.
It's 7:45.
Oh, yeah. We're getting minutely updates now?
Yeah. All right. So, I mean, he's in here to keep us in line and under budget.
Is this thing upside down? Control.
I have no idea.
Does it seem like the nose piece is up there, too?
I have no idea.
I'd hate for it to be back.
Are you Batman?
No, I'm the Lone Ranger, which he did not even address.
Oh. It's supposed to be quick, right? Anyway, let's go.
We talked about Ed's character, but we had time for that one. But not mine. Furries.
And
you didn't even say the word furries. You didn't even mention furries, just for the record. Which is going to make that...
My cunt is the only one that matters here, all right?
Go on.
Turn on the hallway light. Or that work. Don't look at the camera.
It's better if I...
All right, now do the handstand walk.
All right, let's see if I can do the handstand. I don't care. Oh my god, that's so good in blooper. Oh my god.
I can't do it with shoes on.
Is that my beer or your beer?
I don't have a beer yet.
Alright, now sit forward like I just pretend like you're Daniel for a minute.
How's my hair?
On the track, my team's Simon. You're losing this game, we took 11. I'm the breaker of chains, pickle center. People slain, you're dragging.
Those are mine!
Yeah, you said it wrong! I'm showing you how to do it correctly.
Oh, okay. Controversy! What will happen?
I should have.